Okay, so here we're going to have a look at how we change the duration of several clips in one go. And we're going to have a look at changing the duration of clips on the main storyline here, but also as connected clips as well, and look at how we can kind of manage that so we keep those clips all together. So to change the duration of one single clip, we highlight a clip here, and then we can do Control and D, and it will allow us to type in a new duration in terms of, so if we type in 2 dots, it will make that clip 2 seconds long. Okay, now these are images, so we're not dealing with video clips here on the timeline. These are still images that we've brought into Final Cut Pro. The default for my still image duration is 1 second, so now basically when I'm retiming them, highlighting a clip, doing Control and D, I'm changing it to a different time. Okay, so if I want to time all these clips, say to 1/2 a second, I can highlight all those clips on the main storyline. Okay, and then do Control D and type in 0.15, and it will make each of those 15 frames or 1/2 a second long. I'm running at 30 frames per second here. If I come to these clips on the connected, that are connected to the main storyline, then if I highlight those and do the same, so Control and D, and I'm going to make these longer to start with, so I'll make these 3 seconds long, then we're basically going to get something like this, so a big stack of images, so it's stacking them up above the storyline. If I do Control and D and make them shorter, so 0.15, we're going to get a gap between each of those clips. So that could be useful, but we want to look at how we can keep those clips together. So I'm just going to take a couple steps back here. So Command Z. Okay, and basically in order to keep these clips together, we need to group them. So I'm going to do Command and G. Okay, those clips are grouped now, so when I do Control and D now, then type in 0.15, it's going to keep those clips together on this connected group, on this connected storyline. Okay, so that's how to retime clips en masse, so either one at a time by doing Control D, or by selecting multiple clips, and they don't have to be in order either, so we can select clips that are out of order, do Control and D, and then type in 2.15 as an example, and it will change the duration of some clips but not the others, and so on and so forth. So we have a lot of nice flexibility in terms of being able to edit the duration of those clips using the Control D shortcut with one clip selected or multiple clips selected that are in sequence or out of sequence, and then also we've got control over how we adjust those clips when they're on a connected storyline rather than on the main storyline as well. Okay, so that's how to adjust the duration of clips. If you have any questions about Final Cut Pro 10, then please don't hesitate to get in touch, and I look forward to seeing you in the next tutorial.